everyone, welcome to my video, and what we're going to talk about today is Advil versus Tylenol. So Tylenol is, which hand is that? Tylenol is acetaminophen, and Advil is ibuprofen. So for those who don't know me, my name is Dr. Ron. I'm an internal medicine physician, primary care doc, and I want to discuss a few things, and this is probably one of my most common questions in my office. So doc, do I take Tylenol or Advil? And I think we take these for different things. So let's start with Tylenol. This one, Tylenol. So what is Tylenol? Tylenol is a medication called acetaminophen, and it brings down a fever. If you have a fever, and it helps out with aches and pains, but it helps out with your perception of aches and pains. So what you want to do for this is, a lot of people take this for fever reduction and a pain reliever or arthritis and stuff like that, and that's fine. But then this does the same thing. This is Advil, right? Advil is ibuprofen, and ibuprofen does the same thing. It also will bring down your fever, and also, well, it's a pain reliever. In fact, over here it says pain reliever and fever reducer, and it says the exact same thing, pain reliever and fever reducer, on the Tylenol. So which one's which? Which one's better, right? So let's talk about these two medications and what class is there. It's a Tylenol sort of in its class on its own, the acetaminophen class, okay? Tylenol is processed through the liver, and it gets broken down, and the metabolites can be potentially toxic to the liver if you take too much of it. And if you take a lot more of it, it can also be toxic to the kidneys, okay? Advil is called a NSAID, or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug, NSAID. And NSAID does a lot of things. And NSAID, not only does it reduce pain and fever, it reduces inflammation, and that's something that Tylenol does not do. And so it reduces inflammation by blocking a biochemical pathway that I will not bore you with, called the COX pathway. But in doing so, it actually also prevents the production of something called prostaglandins. And prostaglandins are something that you need to protect the lining of your esophagus and stomach. Okay, so that's why people who take too much of the ibuprofen or anything in the NSAID category, whether it be ibuprofen or naproxen, people who take too much of NSAIDs tend to have issues with their stomach, like reflux or gastritis, which is the inflammation of the stomach, or esophagitis, which is the inflammation of your esophagus, and they tend to get reflux from it. And if you take it over a long period of time, and it doesn't take a lot, it just takes a little bit over a long period of time, the prostaglandins that are supposed to be there to protect your stomach is no longer there anymore, and you can develop ulcers in your stomach and ulcers in the first part of your small bowel. And it's not very pleasant, because these ulcers can potentially be life-threatening if there's exposed blood vessels that's inside the lining of the stomach and you start bleeding into it. And that's why people go to the hospital. So how do you know if you've taken this for so long, ibuprofen or naproxen, or any of the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs for so long, that you might need see some medical attention? It was because, well, one thing, look at your bowel movements. Your bowel movements have blood in them, so the blood can either be red or it could be absolute black. And when I say black, I'm talking about charcoal black, tar black. We call it black tarry stools. And if you have black tarry stools, you most likely have something called a upper GI bleed, which means there is some blood vessel up here that's bleeding, and it's going into your stools and causing that black color. If you see that, and you've had that, you need to go to your doctor immediately, like now. Like, if not now, then maybe 2 minutes from now. Okay? Because you need to get checked out for that. Okay, and so yes, Advil or ibuprofen can reduce fevers or pain, And it reduces inflammation, but the downside is that in reducing the inflammation, it also reduces prostaglandins, which protects the lining of your stomach. All right? So you have to know what you're taking. Advil, the other thing is that NSAIDs like ibuprofen and like this can also cause many things to go wrong with the kidneys, even if you take a small amount of it. Okay? And the kidneys are a filter. There's two filters in your body, the liver and the kidneys. And this goes through your kidneys and it can become toxic to your kidneys. And like I said, only even if you take a little bit, and especially the older you are, the more toxic it can be. Even if you take a little bit for even a short amount of time, you can develop kidney failure. And kidney fail, how do you know if kidney failure? You start kind of retaining water, you start feeling really lethargic, you just don't feel right. Kidney failure, there's not a whole lot of pain associated, you just don't feel right. And if you don't feel right, definitely go to your doctor. Okay? So, if you have reflux problems or if you have kidney problems, you want to stay away from this and use this instead. Got it? We have kidney problems. And if you have stomach problems, stay away from this and go to Tylenol or acetaminophen instead. Okay? So let's talk about this a little more. Now, Tylenol, people are able to tolerate larger doses of the Tylenol and without any harmful effects than people are able to tolerate Advil. Okay? Tylenol goes to the liver. Acetaminophen can potentially damage the liver. But you will have to be taking, let's see, this is 5 milligrams. So you will have to be taking about 5 grams for it to hurt the liver, which means 10 of these pills, okay? Now, if you take less of it, it doesn't mean that you can't have liver damage. You can. Or if you take more than 5 grams of this or 10 pills of this, it doesn't guarantee that you're gonna have liver damage, okay? But liver damage from Tylenol is a serious thing. We put people in an intensive care unit for this, and we watch and monitor them and actually put them on the liver transplant list. That's how serious Tylenol can affect you. All right. Now that I've scared the bejeebers out of you, you're going to be wondering why Advil and Tylenol are over-the-counter medications if they have all these effects, right? And I kind of wonder the same thing myself. There's a lot of over-the-counter medicines that are far more dangerous than the ones we actually prescribe, but why that is beyond me. Okay, but like I said, one thing about Tylenol is not an anti-inflammatory. It's purely, if you're using it for pain, it's purely decreasing your perception of pain. It's not really acting on the inflammation of a joint or a bursa or anything else. Okay, so if you have no medical problems, which one would you take, right? You have no medical problems, you have no gastric problem or stomach problems or esophageal problems or reflux problems, you have no kidney problems, go ahead and take your ibuprofen and Advil. This is actually pretty good I like this better for joint pains because it's anti-inflammatory. If you have osteoarthritis or any other arthritis, I mean this can work pretty well. Okay. Or Tylenol is just reduce your perception of pain, but it does not work on, it's not a good anti-inflammatory. Okay? For fevers, they're equal. And for people who are the flu and just really bad fevers and can't keep down, I tell them to alternate between Tylenol and Advil or acetaminophen and ibuprofen or any of the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medications. Okay, and I'm not gonna be commenting on kids because I'm not a pediatrician. I'm an internal medicine doctor. I just focus on adults. But once again, these two, these are over-the-counter medications, but both of them can have potentially harmful effects. So be careful. Okay, this is just hitting the basics of these two medications. But these are from my pantry. I have them in my house, and I rarely take them. But if I had to, I would take them. Okay. if you are not sure, please go and ask your doctor. There's a lot of other considerations I didn't go into, but please ask your doctor before you make that decision. This is just scratching the surface, okay? You know, don't take this as official medical advice for you. This is just me providing a little bit of value, an overview of what these medicines can do and how it can potentially harm you. But always go see your doctor for the official advice. Please see your doctor for that. Okay? Thanks a lot, guys.